and the Bishop of Wheeling-Charleston, Mark Brennan, wants the former bishop to pay back hundreds of thousands of dollars. Now, this follows a series of allegations against Michael Bransfield.
At the request of Pope Francis, Bishop Brennan of West Virginia releases a plan of amends for disgraced Bishop Bransfield. It calls for Bransfield to pay the diocese back more than $792,000 and apologize to those he was accused of sexually harassing and intimidating. Bishop Bransfield submitted his letter of resignation to Pope Francis last year after reaching the mandatory age of retirement, 75. He had served the Diocese of Wheeling-Charleston for 13 years. Pope Francis accepted it. In July, the Pope said former Bishop Bransfield may no longer reside in the diocese he used to lead or participate in any public celebration of the liturgy, and that he must make amends for some of the harm he caused. Yesterday's statement from Bishop Brennan requesting apologies and repayment of funds, it aligns with the Pope's decree and with church investigations this year.
The investigation, which I was asked to conduct on behalf of the Holy See, determined that the allegations of sexual harassment of adults by Bishop Bransfield are credible.
West Virginia Attorney General Patrick Morrissey sued Bransfield and the diocese, alleging covering up criminal behavior. Morrissey says it is time for the diocese to truly come clean and begin to put this horrific scandal behind it. Church leaders vow to stay vigilant.
We will not relent in our determined efforts to bring about the reform and renewal of the church and to restore the credibility, confidence, and trust of the faithful.
And that was Archbishop Laurie, but Bishop Brennan says the money Bransfield would pay back would be used for counseling for abuse victims. Bransfield says he did nothing wrong. 75,000 Catholics live in the Wheeling-Charleston diocese. It includes 95 parishes in West Virginia.